what you guys want to do on offense just a couple of days away from the first game?
Very comfortable. We're getting there. We have another few days of practice, but I'm really excited to get the field. I think we're getting better every day, and I think we'll be in good shape by Sunday.
What do you take out of a close loss last year? I know you got different schemes, but what do you take out of that close loss that you can apply Sunday?
You just want to beat them as much as you do. Anyways, it's been a long time since I've competed against anyone that's not in a UCLA jersey. So I'm excited just to get in the field and play football again.
Is it kind of potentially a nice kind of palate cleanser to start the season again with them? Obviously you want the season to go a different way, you can kind of get that taste out of your mouth.
Yeah, I fully agree with that expression. That's it definitely is a palate cleanser.
From a volume standpoint, how does what you guys will go into this game with compared to, you know, the last two seasons playbook-wise?
I'm not going to really speak too much on the playbook, but schematically we're going to attack a few different things. We're going to go into this game with a little bit of a different mindset, but I'm excited with the game plan we have.
Coach Fish was saying that he's going to rely on you to provide feedback and input in terms of what you're the most comfortable with. What is that process like for you, going back and forth with him, kind of fine-tuning the game plan, I guess?
It's a little bit of basically him putting in a bunch of plays and trying to teach them to me as best he can, if I don't feel comfortable with one by game time or the day before, night before, then we'll scratch it off, because he doesn't want me going into a game with anything that I'm anything less than supremely confident in. And at the same time, I want him to have as big of a call sheet as he wants. So it's on him to kind of respect what I feel comfortable with. It's on me to give him and put as much of my time into it as I can to let him have as much freedom as he can. So it's a two-way street, and I think he's got a great game plan, and I'm really excited to go and execute it.
Do you see a lot of difference in the Texas A&M defense this year as opposed to last year, except for the big exception of Myles Garrett not being there?
Well, we haven't really seen many of their games this year because they haven't played any. You can watch some of their players from last year and just kind of, you obviously, you know, who's graduated and who's still there, so kind of early games in the year, you have to just a bit of mixing and matching a puzzle, but they've got a lot of really good guys coming back.
How much A&M film have you watched from last year other than just the game that you played against them?
A lot. A lot of film.
Every single game?
Something like that.
The time that you missed to injury last year, how did that change you as not just a football player, but as a man respecting the game, or what was it that you learned?
I learned a lot. I'm going through an interesting time in my life with college and just learning who I am, and you mix a nationally covered injury into it, and kind of you get something on the other end. And I've just learned a lot about everything. Perspective on life, football, school, family, all of the above.
Where's your confidence level with the running game? Obviously, that's going to be in the offensive line doing what they need to do to protect you and get the running game going.
I'm just excited to, because obviously we want to keep all of our guys safe on the practice field, be physical and safe. So I'm excited when the whistle's not going to be blown dead on first contact. To see how Bolu and Soso and Nate Starks, all these guys, see how they run after contact. And that's, I think, what we're really good at. And I'm really excited to see it play out.
Sunday when you guys play, it could be triple digits. You know, it's hotter than a pistol out here now. Coaches say, for lack of a better word, suck it up, get the scab. Is that accurate? Do you feel the heat? Can you do anything other than just the obvious hydration?
Yeah, and Coach Alessi's got all that dotted I's and crossed T's.
So meaning that you'll know when to hydrate? What do you mean by that?
He takes care of us mostly physically with our trainers as well, and what fluids we want to take before the game and what salts and stuff we want to take during the game and how to eat, how to sleep, that's our coaching staff does an incredible job.
Notice it. You're not going to play on this type of turf Sunday.
you noticed the past couple of days in the midst of this heat, man, it's hot. I need to hydrate more.
In camp, initially you get a little bit tired at first, but you fight through it. I mean, we've been in San Bernardino the last 2 years.
Sure.
Coach has been more than that. I've been for the last 2 years. And that was definitely a lot worse. And we're on a turf field. It's kind of hot, so you just kind of suck it up. It's football.
One more question.
Apology for the feature question, but now that you've traveled a lot, can you explain to people from afar, like the opposite coast, what it's like to grow up in Manhattan Beach, what you got out of it, how much the beach was part of your life, and whether you can surf?
I'm not a surfer, but I go out with friends every now and then. But Manhattan Beach has actually changed a lot in the last 10, 15, 20 years. But it was awesome growing up. It was a great community. We had beach nights on 5th Street with the Freedmans. So it was a great time. I still got a lot of friends from back there. And they come out to practice and games, support me, and they're off all around the country doing some incredible things. So it was awesome growing up there. Loved it, and happy on the rest of it.
Thank you.